the hearings.
With one unified voice, the disabled of California said today, we have waited long enough. And with that, the rally outside the old federal building, which houses the HEW offices, reached a climax. The physical support was impressive and offered the mental and vocal backing that those inside really needed. It is nearing 2 weeks now since 150 handicapped people moved into the HEW offices. And it was today, in response to that occupation, that a special congressional hearing convened.
Handicapped protesters and reporters face Congressman Phil Burton and George Miller. Debbie Kaplan.
I think one of the things that Secretary Califano and his representatives, who we've been negotiating with since they came into office, forget is that when they sit around and intellectualize about what started off as 8 issues, then it escalated to 15 issues, then it went up to 18, then it went up to 25, and God knows where it's going to go next, is that while they sit around and think about how they're going to enforce regulations, that they don't seem to understand our lives are not changed, our civil rights are not granted. And I personally react to that. That's my civil rights they're messing around with.
Ed Roberts.
And I found, and millions of other people with disabilities are finding, that access, that my ability to move around, and that my ability to regain the pride in myself as a person with a disability is one of the most important things that's coming out of what's happening here today. And to see hundreds of people with disabilities rolling, signing, using canes, the more severely retarded people for the first time joining us in this incredible struggle, is one that leads me to believe that we're going to win this. We're down to the bottom line, down to the basic issue here. Are we going to perpetuate segregation in our society? We're one of the largest minorities in this country. I looked at the 18 points that HEW put out this morning. I have never seen a better blueprint for segregation. These kinds of issues, the issue of civil rights, of human rights, are not one issues that people with disabilities can compromise any further.
Phil Newmark.
If they had to choose the most important part of these regulations to eliminate and to reconsider, they chose them. So I resent the fact that they say we're in fundamental agreement. We're not in fundamental agreement. We're in fundamental disagreement.
Judy Heumann.
Whether there was a Section 504, whether there was a PL 94-142, there was a Brown versus Board of Education. The harassment, the lack of equity that has been provided for disabled individuals, and that now is even being discussed by the administration, is so intolerable that I can't quite put it into words. I can tell you that every time you raise issues of separate but equal, the outrage of disabled individuals across this country is going to continue. It is going to be ignited. There will be more takeovers of buildings until finally maybe you begin to understand our position. We will no longer allow the government to oppress disabled individuals. We want the law enforced. We want no more segregation. We will accept no more discussion of segregation. And I would appreciate it if you would stop shaking your head in agreement when I don't think you understand what we are talking about.
Judy puts her head in her hands. Behind her, disabled participants and reporters clap. To Washington. disabled representatives prepare to go to Washington, D.C.
The group this afternoon put the final touches on their next plan of action. They're taking their protest to the source. 14 handicapped demonstrators and 8 attendants will fly tomorrow to Washington, where they hope to see President Carter himself, or at least tell HEW Secretary Joseph Califano themselves how they feel.
Outside the HEW building, Washington, D.C.
It was sweltering, hot, but they went to HEW anyway, staying in the streets when the curbs stopped them. They were trying to force a meeting with Califano after he had canceled one scheduled earlier, but they were blocked.
Judy Heumann.
I felt like I was being excluded from a building that I pay taxes to keep open, and I am absolutely mortified that President Carter is allowing this to go on. His open door policy certainly is not very open, and to have these big 6-foot, 7-foot cops standing there with people my size is the most ludicrous thing that I have ever been involved in.
Back in Washington today, more than 100 people marched in front of the White House. The demonstrators would be content if Carter would only put pressure on the HEW director, Califano, to sign the civil rights bill guaranteeing the rights of handicapped people. But it doesn't look as if Carter will even do that. It looks even less promising for Carter to see the demonstrators personally, even though they've traveled there from San Francisco for that very purpose. And in the meantime, the group of handicapped people are sticking to their guns here in San Francisco. Today starts the third week of their sit-in at the old federal building.
San Francisco's kind of a special and unique place. After all, it's the only place in the country where the blind and the deaf and the arthritic, the retarded and the para and the quadriplegic, those with cerebral palsy and muscular dystrophy, can get it together enough to journey 6,000 miles to fight for their civil rights. They came home tired tonight, but they're justifiably, I think, quite proud of their trip.
Victory.
Good evening. 35 million Americans, handicapped Americans, won a big victory today. When HEW Secretary Joseph Califano signed a paper today, the implementation of the law began.
Outside the old federal building in San Francisco, the protesters leave the building one by one.
But I discovered something about myself that I didn't know, that I counted as a person, and through 504, I now have more of a chance to count. And I just really feel fantastic.
State Senator Milton Marks accompanies the demonstrators leaving the building. They're smiling, holding signs, and waving. A woman in large sunglasses smiles into the camera.
This is the beginning. It's a huge, tremendous beginning. It's really a leap forward for us.
The protesters wheel out of the building. Some have plastic crates with belongings. A woman with a cane is hugged by two of her friends. The mood is jubilant. Everyone is smiling and waving. Kitty Cohn.
The signing of the regulations signified the public birth of the disability rights movement. It ushered in an era of disability activism, empowerment, and legislative victories based on the legal concepts of non-discrimination and integration embodied in Section 504.
To the heroes that were inside and outside the building. Produced by Dan Veltri, Treehouse Video, San Francisco. Written by Lynette Taylor and Jim Meek. Special thanks. The 504 Sit-In 20th Anniversary Committee. Center for Independent Living, Berkeley, Computer Technologies Program, Disability Rights Education and Defense Fund, Disabled Students Program at UC Berkeley, Independent Living Resource Center, San Francisco, Rose Resnick Lighthouse for the Blind, World Institute on Disability, archival materials, Mary Lou Breslin, Joni Brevis, Kitty Cohn, Holland DeLille, Avril Harris, Joan Leone, Ken Stein, Pamela Walker. Associate producer, Kathleen Duffy. Assistant editor, Marla Leach. Music, Dan Veltri. Audio description provided by Audiovision San Francisco. Describer, Shelley Johnson. Copyright 1997, the 504 Sit-In 20th Anniversary Committee.